Dude, you trying to fight, man? You trying to fight?
I can't believe how much of a struggle you have in your body.
Ain't no struggle, dude. Look at this fucking. Hear that?
Yeah. It sounds like when I go to a pig farm, I'm like, ooh, baby, this fucking pig ready. Sweet! Sweet! Puro sweet!
Fucking ages.
Come on. Bro,
are you not going to take off that?
Dude, this guy, you know, he's trying to hold on to his 20s, but, you're not even 20 anymore. This guy is trying to hold on to his youth, dude.
Always,
like,
all day.
Hard, dude.
Gee.
What's up, bro?
Bro, what's that, a bulletproof vest for your nipple? Yeah.
No, it's breast support, dude.
Breast support. It's a milking machine.
It's a milking machine, yeah.
Whoa, man. This is fashion, my guy.
Gee, I sent you.
This is fashion.
You fashion? Shut the fuck up.
Hey, bro, sent you the other one that you should have.
Oh, no, I'm going to get it.
You're not getting it, bro.
We're going to get it soon.
He's fucking lying to you, bro.
We're going to get it soon, dude.
This guy. This guy doesn't know what he wants in life, man.
Oh, man. I'm still trying to figure out that out.
You realize you post salt and pepper on chicken, dude.
After
fucking talking up a game about how his chicken parmesan was
going to change. My shit was fire.
Chef's kiss.
I did that too. After the first bite, a chef's kiss, man. That's what I did.
What chef, bro? Fucking Ratatouille does better than you, bro.
Dude, hey, I'm fucking learning, bro. Like I said before, like I said in the pre-podcast, I just now really just starting to get into cooking. It took me, I don't know, maybe like
10 years?
30 years?
8.
30 years?
What do you mean?
No.
When did you start learning how to cook?
7?
As a child, probably. 10 years. 11, 12, maybe?
Damn. The last 10 years, I've been just eating out. Yeah. 10 years. Don't suck it in now, dude.
He's sucking it in, man.
Last 10 years, honestly, I've just been eating out and stuff, man.
Yeah. I know.
Not good.
Yeah, not good.
But
not
right
good.
Now, I'm like I've told Shaq before. We like,
you know, transitioning.
This guy, you know, calls me every day and shit. You know, so.
I gotta keep him honest, bro, with life, because I call him, bro. What are you doing? This guy's wiping the crust off his eyes at 12 noon. I'm like, guy.
Why you shaking your head, motherfucker?
Guy.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I call you.
I work overnight, my dude.
Doing what?
Working. Hey, just remember the podcast is called Daily Insomnia, right? It's named after my insomnia.
That's facts, dude.
Talking about that, guys, welcome back to Daily Insomnia. This is episode 288. I want to say enough. 288, if not 289, one of the two. We got the Salt Babe over here who lives on Italian
Italian seasoning.
Italian seasoning right here.
Fucking
that was a cure for all, you know. He's kind of that witch doctor from the 1800s.
Dude, that
would go around town selling Italian seasoning.
Yeah, dude, that was this guy, bro. He's the kind of guy that's like, you know what? This essential oil is for you.
The snake oil?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, snake oil.
Yeah.
Snake oil salesman over here, dude.
God, dog.
Nah, dude. You gotta change the way you look at life, man.
Hey, man. Hey, like I said, right now I'm just barely getting into the whole mix of kind of cooking, kind of, you know, exploring a little bit of the kitchen. Sure. So, you know, I'm trying to find myself, you know.
Yeah.
Just like life, you know. Being in the kitchen is like life, you know. Just trying to find yourself, you know.
Yeah.
Gotta see what knife cuts the best, you know. What seasoning to use, you know. Salt and pepper obviously goes on everything now.
Yeah. Oh,
you know, you just boil chicken in water and eat it.
Yeah, dude. I was like, you know,
you talking about that new age cooking?
Yeah. I mean, this chicken's pretty good, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, low sodium, you know.
That's about incredible that you didn't know that, dude.
I did not know that.
Yeah,
dude. But great. I have friends that
you also know that window breaks, you're supposed to fix it.
Right? Hey, we don't talk about that.
You know what I'm saying?
It ain't my business anymore.
Right. You know when the tire is flat, you change the tire, right?
Always, bro.
Make sure, man. I gotta start reminding you of these basic.
All that stuff gets done, bro. Oil in the car gets done. Blinker fluid gets replaced every time, right?
Blinker fluid.
Yeah,
blinker fluid. Yeah.
Gets replaced all the time.
I can see him putting in blinker fluid.
Dude.
This is like, hey, vegetable oil, same thing, right?
Yeah. No.
My car runs on water, bro, right?
Hey, be careful, bro. The last couple guys talked about that. Hey, off those motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Be careful, bro. You can be on the chopping block.
Yeah.
Let's be honest here. If Kamal had the responsibility of protecting and raising the family, how long did that family last? Let's be honest.
We talk about like new age or talk about like back in the old
We're talking about hey, new age, old age. Old age, non-existent. You die. You die with the family, right?
Hey, new, everybody
I die, I die protect the yeah. family. I die protect
new
the
age, family. Like how long do you could keep your family afloat?
Depends. Is there money involved? Meaning, am I rich? Or am I not rich?
You selling kids to the fucking trade market? Yeah. What are you doing, dude?
Hey, we won't say that. Right. We won't say that at all. Right? Hey, dude. It's just on the internet, right, bro?
You hit the black market,
yeah, no.
Selling lungs.
What I'm trying to say is, if you're a rich man with a family.
Hey, come on, you broke, right?
Oh, that's like, some me right now. Okay, yeah no. That shit.
How long do you think you're gonna keep, you keep somebody a, else alive?
You got a solid 24 hours.
Right? My family will leave me. They'd be like, "I'm taking the kids." I'm like, "All right, well, shit. I got a nice cardboard box right now." You know what I'm saying?
I got a new washing machine that came in a box. Yeah. The fuck we living in,
dude? I'm sleeping in the washing.
Father, but you know you take the cereal out of the box. What? You just don't bite into it? Like, no, father.
I'm making armor, right?
Yeah, yeah, dude, you need some basic living skills, dude. That's what I'm trying to realize.
Honestly,
being that you made it this far in life, surprising. Living on this basic understanding of how life works. Like, I'm just glad you know how to use a debit card. You know what I'm saying? Because if you didn't know how to use cash and debit card and do a little bit of math, dude, you in the gutters.
Hey, math's my strong suit.
No.
Math's my strong suit.
You know your strong suit? Hey. Eating. All kinds of eating. You get what I'm saying? Right.
I'm gonna tell nobody
what
else.
What are these basic things that you think I need in a hypothetical story?
No. In real life, dude. It's real life. Hey, we playing pretend.
The fuck we started talking about hypotheticals here.
See, we're talking about in a hypothetical multi-universe. What would that Gamal need to survive?
Well, I'm just worried about this fucking dude right next to me currently. Right now what you need is that you need basic understanding of how a kitchen works.
Okay.
Right? Utensils, ingredients, understand that everything's go spoiled. I hope you understand that.
Yeah, I know that.
Things will stay fresh forever.
You know, that's facts, yeah.
Obviously, you need to understand that. You know, the bacteria of using the same utensils on different types of meats.
Cross-contamination.
Exactly.
I read that somewhere.
You know what I mean? You don't put the chicken, the poultry above the meat. You know what I'm trying to say? You kind of keep everything separate so the drippings don't fall.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about, dude?
Yeah, let's salmonella.
Yeah, of course.
I'm always worried about something else, man.
But always. Obviously, in saying that, when I say this, I mean, you're this is meaning that you have a fridge that is full and not just bottles of water and... In a collection of empty bottles on top of your fridge, dude. Like you still at a frat party, dude. This is fucking dude.
There's more glass on there. There's more glass on there than there is on his windows.
Yeah. and you wonder why your parents are disappointed, dude. Like, they come home, they see bottles empty on the fridge. They're like, what is he doing? Recycle, my dude.
More glass there than there is on the window. I'm telling you, it's true.
Yeah, you can use those glasses, crush it up,
melt it again,
and fucking put a new window in your house, dude. Yeah, dude, you'd be saving money right now.
What, 4 years with the window?
It's been a minute. I think it might be. 4 years. Am I hitting 4 years? Yeah. I think I might have hit 4 years.
Yeah. Bro, yeah. Hey, dude, your window is fully vested into this 401k.
That window's strong, dude. It's still up there, man.
I did
a great taping job. Yeah, dude. Because when I go buy it, like in the winter, you know, just kind of like look at it. There's no wind. There's nothing.
Okay? I feel like when women come over to sleep over, they should all leave disappointed. Like, oh, I've hit rock bottom. I've hit rock bottom in this life.
Before. Now, I mean, now, you know.
Yeah.
Now that one woman that comes over, she's like, you know what? I'm used to this.
Yeah.
Hey, I live in a white neighborhood. This is the hood for me.
There's a moment when she's laying in bed and she's just like she's reconsidering her life decisions. She's like, man,
I miss you, bro.
You know, I could have married.
Could've been better, huh?
A man with
some money.
With some money.
With some money, dude.
Yeah, dude. You're just not built for it, man. You're just not built for it, dude. It's okay, man.
Hey, okay. I'm working on it, dude. Yeah, I'm working on it. Yeah. Slowly but surely. I'm switching things up, man.
Okay.
Like what?
A better human being for society.
Like what?
Like what?
Like what?
Give me one thing you've contributed to society to being a better person.
I'm taking away from my society a lot.
You got
especially my sprint days.
You got to update Lexus.
His friend is horrible, dude. I took away.
Have you updated your license plates?
Everything's updated. Everything's solid.
Hey, bro.
Oh, shit, dude.
Hey, bro.
Everything's solid. Everything's updated,
dude, you know what it took? A lot of calls early in the morning.
Yeah.
It did.
Yeah, you took them there or what's up?
Bro, almost.
Walked inside.
Dude, I called them. I was like, dude, leave the phone on the toilet while you're showering so I know you're showering, goddammit. You know, to get the fuck out the house.
Yeah, let me hear that.
Let me hear that,
the soap ladder up.
Here's my thing. Why I waited so long was because, one, I was highway all the time. Oh, I was on the highway, so I had nothing to worry about. Yeah. The plate.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I barely was driving on the roads, you know what I'm saying? All highway. All tollway.
You know, I don't know what you're saying, dude. Hey, man. Here's one thing you miss in life.
Tell me.
You don't take fault for anything you do in life. You've never committed a mistake. You know, he's never admitted to a mistake.
I've taken faults. No. Okay,
Name one.
I've taken faults.
I can't think of one.
Yeah. I'm pretty perfect, to be honest. You know what I'm saying?
You know, I'm actually, you know, his thing is funny.
I procrastinate a lot. I could.
Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah.
At the highest level, dude. Procrastination. Yeah, I literally wait for the last minute to do fucking anything, and it's horrible.
Last minute is what I do. I just see the minute, and you're like, let's go around that fucking minute. And just go forward a couple years, and then we'll get this fucking. We'll come back to the fucking issue.
We'll come back, and then we'll address it.
And then you know what? And it ain't my fault. It's their fault.
God, that's their fault. But you know what I'm saying? You know. No, I mean, like I said, I procrastinate a lot, and that is my fault. But like I said, I'm trying to change that slowly.
No, just change it.
I'm trying to change that slowly.
You make it seem like every change in life is it takes steps.
It's a progression.
It's just a progression kind of change. You know, it's like one day you're like, you know what? I'm gonna start waking up early. You just wake up early.
Oh no, this guy's been talking about fixing his sleep schedule for what, 4 months now?
It's been more than four months, but I'm gonna give him 4 months.
No, it's been more like
I got anxiety sometimes. I'm like just tossing and turning, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, bro. No, suck this meat. 4 in the morning, bro. That's beyond fucking
sometimes. Fucking. Right now it's been like 3, so I'm cutting it.
3 where?
I'm trying to get down to 2.
3 where?
So, what are your
Yesterday was 2.
When you fall asleep, what do? Like, what is your regimen?
Like, fall asleep?
Yeah, like you go to bed and wash your teeth, wash your face, put some lotion on your body. And then you go.
I butter up, you know what I'm saying?
You butter yourself up. You get in your sleep, your PJs, and you
straight PJs, bro.
Yeah, birthday suit, bro.
A little
lotion on the rod, and we're good to go.
All his fucking blankets had pee-pee stains on them.
I clean my shit.
They all got pee-pee stains.
My bedding, my stuff. I mean, gets washed every.
Are you comforter and all that stuff?
Yeah. Gets washed every 10 days.
Yeah, but 10 days there's pee-pee stains on that. Shit. Come on, you don't think you leak a little bit?
No, dude, I don't got that issue, bro. All right?
No, come on. You are the issue, my dude.
No, I'm, dude. When it comes to that shit, I'm very, very clean.
Yeah, you're very clean.
I like to be very, very clean. You know what I'm saying?
I'm not mad at him.
Very, very clean has to, man. You never know.
Nah, bro.
Wait, what else you got, bro? What else you got?
Hey, bro. Bro, let's start with that. Let's start with your sleeping schedule.
I got to fix it.
I feel like... No.
What is this? That intervention, dude?
Yeah, yeah.
What the fuck we doing?
It's after you made me split a drink?
fucking intervention. I mean, start with just the simple shit.
All right, tell me,
Shark. Once you start with your sleeping schedule and you can wake up and conquer your morning, bro, the rest of it is going to fall into place in some order. Mm. Yeah. No, honestly speaking, like if Miracle Morning, have you ever read the book Miracle Morning?
No, I do audio books. All right,
Miracle Morning.
That's something I read. I'll read it.
I'll listen to it.
The Miracle Morning. You gotta listen to that, dude. You conquer your morning, you conquer your day. Mm-hmm. You know, if you wake up, let's say at 7 in the morning, I'm not gonna say 5 or 4 or any stupid ass thing like that.
Yeah,
goal is 7.
Yeah, you wake up at 7 in the morning, dude, every day, like, and you don't go to sleep till about 10. Dude, your whole day is yours. Guaranteed it's yours.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, there's a fine line when it comes to all that. Because it's like I'm good in the morning. I wake up. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, just come, dude, obviously there's times when I'm like, fuck, it's like 15 more minutes, right? So we all have those.
Hit the snooze.
Yeah. But, like, I wake up and I'm good. You know, like, my thing that annoys me when people wake up and they're like, don't talk to me, too early. Oh, yeah, like, get the fuck out of here, dude.
Yeah, that's pretty.
Like you should have stayed sleeping.
Hey, you survived another night.
Exactly. Your sleep apnea didn't kill you this tonight, bro.
Look, if this would have been the whole world, you survived tigers, you survived some wolves, some hyenas.
Exactly, man. Dude. Like, god damn. Like, some people do get on my nerve. I'm not in the mood today. Why the fuck did you come to look at me?
Don't talk to me until I had my first coffee. Like, fuck off with your
friends. Yeah, like, you know what? You know what? Drown on the coffee in your sleep, bro.
It's like, I hope you make tomorrow's coffee. I'm going to smother your ass when you go to sleep tonight. I'm going to fucking hit you with that
pillow. Hold tight.
You're supposed to save people, not kill people, right, dude?
What?
No.
I'll take you.
Do you shed a tear when you're suffocating somebody? Just fucking live.
You just fucking hold on for dear life.
God damn.
You ever seen a vibrating phone? That's exactly what you wanted to look like. Fucking go.
My suffocating phase is Gamal's fucking masturbating. You know Gamal's a bottom lip biter, dude.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That's you all day, my dude. You bite hard in that lip, dude.
A carne asada.
Gamal's eyes. The life leaves him as he fucking tilts
the demon comes in. Fucking eyes glass.
There's one good video that shows that.
I know, I seen it.
It's in the archives of the memes we used to do for Daily Insomnia.
Damn,
that shit was hilarious, bro.
Yeah, this dude look when he is menacing, dude. It's a very menacing look.
God damn. He's a menace society, bro.
Yeah, he's a menace.
Menace society.
Look at him.
God, hey, bro. Conquer your morning, bro.
I'm conquering my morning. I'm conquering my morning tomorrow.
That's a lie. Let's drag in the day after tomorrow.
All right, cool. I'll give him one day.
Yeah.
You know what?
I'm not going to fight you, Shaq. I'm not going to fight you.
Nothing about it. This week doesn't work for you, man.
Yeah, I'll start next week.
Fucking ain't guy. Dude, literally, bro, I go on, when I go to call him, I'll call him at like 8:30, 8 o'clock.
Why are you doing that early, huh? We got shit to do?
What are you trying to do, man? I have a child, guy.
Oh, shit. Dude.
You know, I wake up and take him to school, guy.
Gamal remembers what that feels like.
Hey, dude, literally, dude.
I had a child once.
I literally wake up at 8, you know, 7:30, 8 o'clock. And I call him up. Hey, you know, hit him up. Hey, bro.
Conquer the morning.
Dude, this guy doesn't answer. You know,
let me tell you his excuse, because I've heard his excuse many times. Bro, my fucking alarm didn't fucking wake me up, man.
Sometimes I stick to my alarm.
Yeah, dude. Hey, dude, I've called him like nonstop for like, nonstop. I call him like
four or five times.
Yeah, 15-minute increments. Two different phones. Fucking nada, dude.
Dude, nada, man. I go, you know what I do now? I go on fucking, I go on Messenger. Yeah. I go to Messenger and I'm like, when was the last time he was active? Yeah. Oh, 4 hours ago. Yeah, all right, I got another 3 hours to go before this fucker wakes up.
Yeah.
Like, dude, I'm like, god damn, bro. Dude, his messenger is who tells on him. He went to sleep at 4 o'clock this morning. All right, cool. Fuck it. Yeah. That's what it is. And I'm like,
guy. The strangling the meat.
Yeah, hey, bro. Hey, bro, that chicken is dead, bro.
Fuck it.
That shit raw, dude.
That poor boyito's fucking. Boyito. Fucking chirping, man.
Everybody ain't even chirping him. Everybody's like the bird that flew in the house. Going crazy.
That bird walking around with crutches. He's fucking. I wish I could
fly
again.
Bird on life support. Bird got an oxygen tank.
Oh, man. Yeah, no, that poyito needs some time off, man.
All right, man. So we cock in the morning tomorrow, all right?
Yeah.
What else?
Okay.
Just cock in the morning, bro. Let's start with that. We're not even going to give you too much, bro, because...
Yeah. Do you do your bed?
No.
No. Okay. Not at all.
Okay. No.
All right. I'm glad we agree on something.
No. I got time for that.
No.
Hey, you know, there's something... I mean, I'll say this much. There is something nice. I'm not mad when you go into a bed as, like... made.
Yeah.
And you're like, you fucking go into blankets. Oh, sure. Oh, it feels real nice.
You know, even better?
But it also feels nice just to jump in the fucking bed and then rats are blowing
around.
Yeah,
roll over and Fido goes to sleep.
Yeah, dude. The best feeling, I would say, hotel room.
I love hotels.
Yeah, I just don't like the tucking in at the bottom of the fucking bed.
I know, get some
yeah, no, no, I gotta kick that covers. Shit out.
Yeah,
I got my little feet.
They gotta have room, bro.
Little nubs, bro.
My little nubs. My little nubs over here, man. Look at these fucking calves, dude.
Look at that, dude.
Poodle beach, poodle. Sorry. No, what was that sound? The sweet. What was it?
Sweet.
I'm not a farmer, man. I didn't fucking. That was a combination of oink and a fucking sweet. Hey, you know, hey, Gamal runs long enough, it starts smells like bacon, dude. Fucking, fucking, his thighs rubbing up against
him. Like fuck carnitas, bro. God,
fucking chicharroncito, hey, right
bro,
there.
Big bone, bro. I can't catch it.
Big bone, dude. That's big what you call it, bro?
Yeah, big bone, dude.
Bone's not the bone, you know what I'm saying?
Big bone, you know what I'm saying?
But, hey, guys, so, before we keep moving forward, we got to introduce the drink of the episode, man.
Maybe you introduce the guest.
I'm not a guest, bro.
Shaq's been here.
Our only guy. Black friend, you know what I'm saying?
He's I think he's close to beating Ernesto, man.
I think he beat Ernesto, dude.
We're gonna make it. We're gonna give you the title, man. The most returning guest.
Yeah.
But come on, tell them what drink. We're drinking
the Daily Insomnia original, a little whiskey smash today. Delicious, refreshing, good for the summertime, guys. In stores now.
Just talk to him regular, man. God, do you make it seem like you're selling the drink? Like, hey, man, we're only $10.99.
Here's some new bottle. Whiskey Smash, Daily Insomnia.
Right now, I'm thinking whose face I should cover with the drink. You just got chosen. Your face is covered.
Wait, so how you gonna do the setup?
You're gonna hear your voice. Not see your face.
Drink talking.
Yeah, I'm gonna have me and Shaggy looking, and you're the fucking.
I'm the drink.
Your side covered up, man.
What's up, dude? What's up? Whiskey Smash in stores now, right, guys?
Get out of here.
We got a half a smash on the floor, bro. You didn't even clean up.
I handed you the towels so I could get to that corner. And then you start cleaning up. I'm like, okay.
Yeah. You know, I would kick you out this episode right now. The only reason I'm going to keep you on.
Okay.
Because you have a story to tell, man.
I do have great stories.
You have a great story to tell.
Amazing story, bro.
You went viral.
Yeah.
No, dude. Jeez.
Yeah.
Theoretically.
That could have been me.
By association.
That could have been me. All I got to say is.
Hey, you're a doppelganger.
Definitely doppelganger, dude.
Your doppelganger went viral, bro.
That fucker was 5'5", you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Most of it, you know what I'm saying? Doesn't mean a lot.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, fucking. Update your vocab, my dude. Right? People know what you're saying because you're saying words, right, man? You're not talking to riddles, Mr. fucking Riddler.
But
what I'm saying?
Story time, guys. Story time, all right? I was swiping through the TikToks, you know what I'm saying, of the world.
You say one more time, dude. I'm going to fucking backhand you. Back to Africa, right, dude?
All right?
Middle East, what am I saying?
One of those two hopefully take you. Yeah. But I was swiping through the TikTok. The world's a TikTok, all right? Okay. And I get to this one video, you know? This one video of where this guy zooms in and this couple's arguing. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And this girl straight up in the guy's face telling him to fuck off. Or That's what I got. I mean, you guys see the video.
She said, shut the fuck up, shut bro. The fuck up.
Yeah. Literally roasting him. Roasting him and going hard at him in front of public.
Yeah, you know it's one of the videos where there's a girl yelling at a guy and the guy's just taking it in.
And he's just chill. He's just drinking.
Full, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
And he's just sipping his drink and that dude's just taking it all in.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's saying something, but he's not as angry. He's not as
animated
as how the chick is. And I start looking at the chick. I'm like, oh, shit. I know this chick.
Right away, you how long?
No,
did it take
no. It took me a little bit. I had to do some little bit of cross examination.
No, but I mean, like, what one moment when you watched the video was it like the first view that you're like.
As soon as it zoomed in, I looked at her. I'm like, oh shit! And then I started doing some cross examination.
I bet you did.
Some cross examining. All right, and I matched up certain things to what I saw back in the past. You know, this pre-COVID versus.
One more time.
It's pre-COVID, okay.
I just want to make sure. I want to make sure.
Pre-COVID. It was like, 2.5 years ago?
My COVID or this pre-COVID?
Before COVID even started.
Oh,
right?
Sorry.
It was like 2.5 years ago. So today, this is like the summer of 2019, you know what I'm saying?
Got it.
But,
Cross-examination.
I saw a tattoo that she had in the video. I saw a tattoo that she had in the picture.
Yeah.
Everything matches.
Yeah.
And this girl is just screaming at this dude in public. At a festival.
Yeah.
And like we said, the guy's taking it in. But by some miracle, that guy from the back looked like me. Looked like me, dude.
So that would have been
the back of the head.
That would have been you.
That could have been me.
Not only the guy looked the back of the head, same creases in the back of the neck, right? Literally same, same. There was like no difference between your the back of your neck and the back of his neck, right?
Who did it better? Right?
Yeah. Same
haircut.
Same haircut. Possibly. Same haircut.
It's possibly.
No, it is.
Same style.
Yeah, same style of clothing. Good, man. And good. The skin tone was fucking like on point.
He was pretty close. Yeah, pretty close. He was a little more crispier. Yeah.
But because he was being on the sun, this guy this guy doesn't wake up until 2 p.m. Man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, the sun's gone by the time he wakes up. Yeah.
He gets the sun once it's already down, dude. But yeah, dude, you were that close to being that dude.
I was that close, dude. Yeah, that close.
But you said that you were getting like
I was already getting red flags from her.
Yeah,
I got a huge red flag from her, and that's the one that turned me off from her. I'm like, oh, I don't want to deal with this shit. Right away. And you know what I'm saying? I'm not someone to take bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Someone that doesn't want to deal with bullshit. So I'm like, all right, cool. I didn't even respond to her after that. After what she said, no response. I just like tossed her away. Like I'm done. I'm not gonna deal with this shit, dude.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
She didn't contact me, I didn't contact her. We're on the same page, fine.
Yeah. This is pre-COVID?
It's pre-COVID.
Yeah. Just wanna make sure I get that clear.
It's pre-COVID, you son of a bitch, right? But yeah, no. It was like I said, it's one of those things like I was telling you guys before, like I don't think it's right for a woman to do that. It's not right for a guy to do that. Not in public.
Yeah.
You guys want to argue? Do it in private.
But not only that, but it's like, you know,
people recording everywhere.
People recording everything.
Everywhere. Oh, yeah. Everything's getting recorded.
Yeah, everything's getting recorded.
Yeah. Oh, that. Especially at a festival.
Yeah.
A festival,
oh, that TikTok blew the fuck up.
Yeah.
Blew the fuck up in one day. Blew the fuck up to half a million views.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
How do you know the views? That's the only the likes. How do you know?
It lets you know. Like I'll show you.
Oh, okay. Oh, when you click on the page, it lets you know how many views.
Yeah,
you
got. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha.
So
yeah, you gotta go back to the profile.
Exactly.
And then you see the videos, good. Right? Yeah.
But like I said, I don't condone that. I don't think anyone should be doing that. Especially if you guys are together. That's something you guys could talk about in private.
Oh, right, dude, you know do nothing.
Protect your person in public. Dude, you know what I'm saying? Like, have their back. Yeah, but in private, fucking,
you want to. Oh, bro, lay you the fuck out. Literally.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, if there's one thing that will take me to red zone is public humiliation.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
You know what I'm saying?
I've been there.
Like,
been
if there. You if you do anything in public, even if it's slight, like, if you know when girls do that thing when they're like, oh, come on, baby. Like, you hug her and then they fucking, like. They shoulder check me.
Yeah.
And then like maybe nobody else caught it, or maybe a couple people caught it. I'm like, oh.
You saw me.
All right. I ain't gonna fucking touch you the rest of the fucking night. And guess what?
I'm not even gonna look your way.
You know, I'm not even gonna look your way. Cause I like and I get it. Not ever, you know, you don't want to be hugged all the time.
Yeah.
But when you're making a you know, emotion so people see that you're mad or annoyed with me or with you know your significant other. We got problems.
Yeah, no. Sure. And I'm definitely a fan of behind closed doors when we talk about stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, listen, I will put on the fakest face ever.
Oh, me too.
I will smile, laugh. I'm we're best friends. Say,
yeah, I'm pretend nothing happened.
Dude, we're best fucking friends. Yeah. You know, but once we get in the car, bro, I don't even like you, bro. Like,
oh, you got the tips, bro.
Hey,
I'm already working divorce papers. Yeah. I'm like, my lawyer already.
Texting them all, like, hey, man, start it up again.
Yeah. But that's what people don't understand is, first off, I heard this a while back, you know, you can't tell someone else about your problems because they don't lay up with that person.
Yeah,
you
sure,
know?
For sure.
So you'll forgive them, but that person never forgives them, you know? So
for sure,
the trick of not telling your family about problems that happen in your marriage and you got going on.
Yeah. I think that's key. I think just something you can talk to your friends and your family about, but nothing that paints... But once you paint your partner in a negative
evil,
view,
yeah,
in an evil over. View, and especially like an evil view, yeah. it's hard to change that.
Yeah, because now their perception. See, they don't wake up with that person.
Yeah,
they don't get a good morning kiss. They don't get a I'm sorry, babe. They don't get the pillow talk. They get the fuck you version of that person. Mm-hmm. The hey, look, he's a such and such, or she's a such and such, and it doesn't help your relationship because now those people all they do is badmouth that person in front of you. Whether you love that person to death, they're over here like that person fucking ain't shit, and you're like, come on, guy. I mean, that's why you don't put your business out there.
Every relationship has issues, you know what I'm saying? No relationship is perfect, but you keep like you said, keep the things to yourself and what?
Sorry.
Oh, we laughing at dude.
No, dude.
We laughing at right?
Go ahead, man. Go ahead.
No.
Hey,
fuck you, man. No, but I've been, but like I said, I've been in the that end.
You were in an abusive relationship.
I was in an abusive relationship.
Yeah, like we joke. We, put it, we joke around about this guy.
But used to be.
What
we said used to be, right?
Used to be. He used to be in a very
toxic,
very abusive, like physically abusive. Like you were
humiliated.
Used to be get hit. Used to get hit.
And I block that out of my brain, dude. He knows I don't. Yeah, I block that shit out of my brain.
Like on a daily basis, like there was like a beating that occurred.
Every day of my life, I was dodging.
I'm the dodge. Ass whooping, right?
Lunch came around. That dude was getting beat. That moment, right there.
It was a very, very toxic environment that I was in. Very toxic relationship.
That's crazy.
I mean, I always kept my cool. That's my thing, right? Yeah. I always kept my cool. And
hey, bro, he has really good cool because I've. Hey, bro, have you ever seen fucking Homer and Bart Simpson? I would have been in this motherfucker.
It takes a different kind of human being to take the punishment this man took.
Right? Yeah, I've taken a lot, man. I've taken a lot.
Hey. You bitch.
And it takes a bitch.
I was that guy in the festival. I was that fucking guy in the festival.
Hey,
I was there before.
Yeah. You were, bro.
I was there before.
You know how I should have got home? I don't know who would have been with me.
Yeah, I don't know. Uber. I don't know. It's like I see.
Unless you drove and that's your ride home, bro.
I'd have still got home.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Like, I seen those clips of, I mean, you know, there's so many clips of people breaking up with or catching their partner with like a different person, whatever the case is, right? I saw one that he's been around for a minute, but it popped up again in my feed. Search. Yeah, yeah, the feed. And it was this girl, like, she catches her friend with her boyfriend, and she's like, she's in the restaurant, like, screaming. And yelling, laughing. And
I
think
I showed that one, didn't I?
Yeah, I think you said it.
Yeah, crazy. But
it popped up again. And I'm like, it's just.
She's freaking out. Like, she lost all control.
Yeah, but it's just where do you think this is heading? Like, how do you think this is the. Like, this is going to fix anything.
It's not, dude.
Because you think you're embarrassing him? You're embarrassing your damn self. Because that dude's going to, he's trying to calm her down, you know, in the whole moment. But at the end of the day, he's going to grab your friend, take her back to where they came from.
Dig her down, dude.
And then you're going to be that one crazy girl fucking yelling and screaming, man.
She literally, I'm going to show you the video, dude. She literally loses control in the restaurant, jumping up and down, screaming like bloody murder.
Yeah.
And everyone's just watching. We're just watching.
Yeah.
I went in the comments and like everyone's saying like, oh, she had a panic attack or she has a manic episode. She had a manic episode.
No, I know. I think people will.
I need to see that.
Chalk it up too quickly.
I don't think.
No, for sure. But that's what they're saying. Like, oh, she took so much stress or so much trauma that it made her.
Trauma?
Well, that's what I'm saying. It made her go to that point.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I like how everybody's the fucking colleges.
I passed with a fucking D because of Chris Gale on psychology. So.
Yeah. No, it's
fuck.
Yeah, it just public outbursts is like that.
No,
just I'm not with. Like I would leave. Yeah. I wouldn't spend a moment.
Yeah, because your sanity is not worth anyone else.
Yeah, no,
like
no.
Your sanity, bro. You can't leave that shit up to anyone. You know.
Yeah,
and that's speaking on not even like relationships. That's also speaking on jobs and shit like that. Like things in life. Like really think about how short life is. You know.
Yeah.
Like, that's fast,
dude, your sanity is key. Like your happiness is key. Like, fuck you.
Yeah.
Like, and we have to embrace that more because I'm speaking on myself too. You know, like I don't embrace that enough. You know, because I have certain situations where I'm like, dude, like, why do I even take this? You know, not my relationship. Relationship wise, I love my relationship. I love my wife. Love my kids. You know, and it's amazing. But just other things in life that are like, bro, why do I? You know, why do we take this abuse? It's like fucking. Una piedrita en el zapato, you know?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Stop taking this abuse, you know? Like, that, it might seem like piedrita, bro, but when you take that shoe off, bro, the fucking foot about to fall, you're gangrening, bro.
Yeah.
You know? So it's like, we definitely need to, as humans, as friends, you know, one another, you know, kind of keep each other in check. Like,
but that means, like, that's like full circle. It comes back to the procrastination. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, When you wait last minute, like I said, I have the same fucking issue, but I get it done.
Yeah.
But like, there's a lot of things that I do last minute, and I'm like, you know, if I would just gotten this shit done earlier, I'll have been puro chillax.
Dude, that happened to me like 2 minutes after I woke up late. Like I knew I was gonna be late, or I'm running a little bit behind. I gotta speed up. Like if my stupid ass would have woke up when I said I was gonna wake up, I wouldn't have these problems.
That's facts. Mm-hmm.
You know, but we're human, bro. We're human.
Yeah.
We're not, no one's different. You know, even billionaires, millionaires, whatever the fuck you want to call them, motherfuckers. We're all human.
Yeah.
We all suffer from all types of shit. We all got depression, anxiety. We all
fucked up.
Man. Yeah, we all fucked up, bro.
We got issues, man.
We're a can of fucked up, you know, and it's like we just have to learn how to get with our shit.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's like some of us like our chicken with salt and pepper and some of us don't.
Hey, some of us mayonnaise and fucking Italian seasoning and that's the end of fucking panko breadcrumbs and that's the end of it.
Pour that lard onto that fucking chicken and call it a fucking
that's it, bro.
A day, dude.
It gives it moisture.
Call it night.
It keeps it moist.
God damn, bro. So let's hit the topic real quick. What
topic, bro? What topic we got?
What kind of seasonings do you like, bro? Hey, gosh.
Bro, like I said, I'm just getting into the whole cooking thing, so I'm still trying out different seasonings that I'm gonna like. You know what I'm saying? I ask you all the time, like, hey, what's a good combination for seasoning for this, for that? You know what I'm saying? I reach out to help.
You're hearing yourself, right?
I reach out, yeah.
You're hearing yourself.
How many of the seasonings that we've recommended you have?
No, I'm trying to say.
I have, like, probably all of them, but I don't know a good combination.
You know, there's no wrong combination.
I understand, but sometimes I don't want something to be over too powdery, you know what I'm saying? If you put too much garlic, powder, it might take too much. It might taste too much of like garlic, you know. If I do too much paprika, it's gonna take too much.
Too much paprika.
But as I'm saying, like I don't know what's a good combination. I don't know.
Don't put too much of it.
Yeah, you know what it's called? It's called trying out.
Hey, bro,
it's called mistakes,
and that's what we're trying to
do. Dude.
No, you're not trying to.
No, I have.
Were happy with the Italian and fucking mayonnaise. That was like the fourth time in a row making it that way, dude. God damn. It's like four times in a row, he told me about his chicken parmesan. That was the best things in sliced bread. And he's like, bro,
I'm just happy that I was able to make it and it came out good.
That was edible.
Jesus Christ.
That was edible.
It's going to be better, you son of a bitch. You know what? I'm going to cook you one.
Don't you ever cook me anything.
Wow. Keep it to yourself.
Wow. Keep that shit to yourself. You know,
I was the head chef at Golden Corral.
Yeah. Dude, you're just digging yourself more into fucking. You cooking food for people and you can't cook chicken, man, correctly. Hey, you know chicken's not supposed to be pink in the inside, right?
I know.
All right, 20.
Wait, medium rare is not good.
No. Oh,
shit. A little cluck.
Yeah, dude. I like medium rare, dude.
You want to hear a fucking taco gotta doodle?
dude, we gotta teach you, bro.
I'm learning, man. I'm learning.
Do you have a crock pot by any chance?
I have everything. Yeah. I have all the fucking utensils in the world.
Crock pot.
I got one. Yes.
Dude, you gotta.
I got a crock pot. I got the air fryer. I got an oven. I got a gas stove. You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
what you need in your life?
I need a maid.
No. What you need in your life? You need one of those like either. I mean, obviously you can get the web because you just get a cookbook on the web or whatever. Mm-hmm. One of those things that you know, like you said, a crock pot. You just throw a bunch of shit on there. Dude, you put that shit. You cook that shit for 6 hours.
Low and slow, bro.
And you're fucking set, dude. That's the kind of life you're about, dude.
No.
You're not chopping up parsley and lettuce.
I'm getting into that.
No, you're not.
Do you hear me, dude?
No, I know.
I'm getting into that. It's a slow transition, all right?
Yeah, dude. Dude, by the time you get there, you're dead. By the time that you don't even have teeth to chew anymore, dude.
It's not the journey, but how you get there.
You're
going to
be drinking smoothies, dude, right, dude? You're gonna be.
Is that the journey, bro? It's how you get there, Ramon, right?
Yeah, I'm just hoping you get there, man.
Lucky. Bro, like Top Gun here, dude.
Call me Maverick, right?
Got me, yeah.
Call me Maverick.
El Don.
El Mas
Right.
Yeah, dude. Like, it's good that. Dude. Throw that crock pot out, bro.
Next week, I'm gonna be the best fucking chef ever, dude.
Yeah, but say.
A lot of trial and error.
Dude, next week I'm gonna go to your house. It's gonna be no chicken. I mean, sorry, no pepper, no salt. Dude. All right, I'm gonna see these cornflakes. From 1988, dude.
Hey, you're not like next to the applesauce.
Yeah,
applesauce. Keep bringing up the applesauce.
Hey, bro, dude, some guy pulled out some applesauce. How old is that? Like about 4 years old. Jesus Christ,
dude, that's
wine. Fine wine.
Yeah, that shit that's behind right
that
there.
That shit fermented, bro.
Yeah. Dude, I was going to say, like, we don't give him enough props for him to, like, still be around.
Hey, dude, this man kept himself alive.
We don't give him enough props, man. But this guy should be dead. He should be in the upside down world.
Upside down world. in the multi-universe, I did not survive.
Yeah, but. Yeah. You in this don't even universe you survived in it, dude. you are the number one Gamal.
This guy's gonna be the first one to die in the metaverse. Yeah. First one to die in the metaverse. Oh, we already got somebody that got molested in the metaverse.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's a thing that. Now. I'm like, yeah. What?
Somebody got molested in the
metaverse. You heard that too, right?
No. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A girl got molested in the metaverse.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's fucking wild.
Was it a girl, or was it a? Character
I think
girl.
It's a girl, but I don't. I mean,
I guess we don't know, right? I guess
either way, it's a video game.
Mm-hmm. It is a video game, sure.
It's yeah. a life video
but,
game.
But nowadays, you gotta be careful about everything. You know what I'm saying? Because if you overstep one little thing, it's you're hurting your what's the word I'm looking for?
You know what I'm saying?
You're overstepping someone else's freedom or. Or personal space, or yeah, yeah. all that good
infringing
shit.
Infringing on them.
Yeah, infringing on them. Exactly, exactly.
So, yeah, but still, it's a fucking video game.
I know it's a video game. Yeah. I know.
Dude, anybody remember this fucking San Andreas, bro? I used to pick up hookers in the car all the time, bro.
I used to be in the strip club, bro. I was spending money.
Dude, I committed hate crimes. I'm fucking like
the most dude. Of hate crimes?
Oh, dude. All hate crimes?
Bro, that's the crazy part. Like, it's a video game.
Yeah.
Like, you guys are taking this shit way too serious, bro. Go outside and play in the grass. All you motherfuckers are fucking allergic to fucking air.
Touch your toes, man. Touch your toes.
Dude, I used to have this gym teacher back when I was in elementary school. That every time we would go out to the gym, like, she was, like, very stern.
Yeah.
And she would tell all of us. She would be like, hey, guys, just so you know, you can't, don't start ripping grass. Because I'm extremely allergic to grass. Like, I don't know, whatever, the shit that was released when you rip grass, right?
Stuff, yeah, yeah.
She's like, I'm really, so if you guys do this, I will die, right? And you know what we all used to do? It's fucking ripping. Just ripping grass behind us, dude. I used to rip grass all fucking day, dude. Just fucking. I was just waving that lady to fucking tip over. Just fucking. Dude, she was an asshole too, man. So when she would make me more mad, I was fucking girl that grass.
You
I was
take like, with you?
To sprinkle that shit in the back of my neck, dude.
He said, I'd rub her hands.
Yeah, rub her hands.
Touchy just to make sure she fucking fell out.
Fucking blow shit into her fucking face.
You can't tell someone not to do it because they're just making it.
Well, especially more, a middle. First of all, hey, middle school, that wasn't fun. Not middle school, I'm sorry, in grade school, yeah. That wasn't fun. Like, I wasn't planning on fucking ripping grass.
Yeah.
But you tell me.
They'll do it.
Yeah, you tell me you're gonna fall over and,
yeah. and fucking start. Bro. Yeah.
I'm about to test this out, bro. Cap or fact.
Yeah.
Cap or fact.
Cap or fact. Yeah.
Cap or fact, bro. I was gonna say.
That's the crazy part about shit. Like,
what is your old ass doing outside, you gym teacher? Fuck you.
Dude, why are you a librarian? First off, if you're allergic to life, why are you in this job?
Yeah.
You're in the wrong job.
You're in the wrong job, dude.
That pension, bro. That pension.
Nah. Hey, bro. Some people go for that pension, bro.
That pension.
I know a couple people at 30, bro, and. Don't worry about
that. You know, now that I think about it, dude, you could have been a good gym teacher, man.
Nah.
Right? Doesn't he give you gym teacher vibes?
Yeah, yeah, you
gym
do.
Gym teacher, really?
Hey, bro, yeah. You can't play coach, you know?
Yeah.
That's
Oh, yeah, this is Coach Diaz right here, dude.
It's Coach Diaz.
Coach Diaz.
Hey, back in my prime.
Dude, yeah, back in my prime, Coach Diaz. That's what he is. No,
here's the thing. Here's the thing.
You know, I was this close to making the NFL.
Hey, I was scouted.
Dude, this guy told me.
But I'm in Manila.
Yeah.
This guy told me a story about him throwing a football, dude. All I could imagine was him being Uncle Rico from fucking the Point Dynamite. He's like, I hurt myself throwing a football the other day. I'm like, oh, you Uncle Rico? He's throwing footballs up in the air, catching them.
That shit hurt, bro.
I was like,
I'm all hurt right here, dude.
I was like, you throwing balls and you running over and bringing them back?
I was playing with myself, bro. I was like, no, I was playing with Buddha, bro. I eat Shaq's wife's brother.
Little brother?
Yeah.
Little brother-in-law?
God damn, bro.
The crazy part is, dude, he only threw the ball like 7 times.
Nah, I threw the ball quite a bit of time, Shaq. Hey, you're too busy giving me raw chicken, right?
Hey, you ain't good, though. Guess what my chicken had, though?
That motherfucker was pink.
Hey, guess what my chicken had, though? Guess what my chicken had? Seasonings, bro.
Yeah, dude, you should he didn't tell you this, man, but when he was out there, you know he called me?
Oh, yeah,
he called me. He's like, bro, I'm scared. he's like, bro, there's a lot of urban people around. Yeah, I was like, bro, relax, man.
Dude, like,
this is my family, bro.
Hey, guess what, bro? I seasoned the chicken, though.
That chicken was fire.
The season, hey, bro. Chicken.
I had a good
the chicken thighs. Good
meal. Can you taste the difference between his chicken and your chicken?
Oh, I mean, yeah. That's okay, definitely then, a slight
taste. Salt pepper. That's salt pepper, yo.
And you know the crazy part, bro? I didn't use a lick of fucking salt and pepper.
Shit,
the, that's the trick, bro.
Oh, you did the, the fucking yeah.
Dude, I did the adobo, and dude, I didn't do garlic salt. I did literally adobo.
Really
What was it? Adobo, smoked paprika, garlic, onion, and applewood. Applewood seasoning.
It was delicious.
Applewood smoked seasoning.
Dude, the banana pudding though yesterday,
it slaps.
Fuck, so good, dude.
Hey, you know the crazy part?
So good.
He's trying to be all modest. I don't, you know, Shaq. I'm not gonna take a plate to go home. I'm like, bro. Fucking take a plate,
take
bro.
A plate home?
I took some.
Kamal, if there's one thing, Kamal lacks is modesty, dude.
Bro, he was modest.
This dude eat.
I'm not Ernesto, right? I'm not Fabiola.
Ernesto.
Right? I'm not those two. They were fighting over the spoiled goods, bro.
Yeah.
They're fighting over the goods.
I don't know, but that's something else. That's just like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, when you can't bring food to a party and then take it with you.
It was a Friendsgiving. It was a Friendsgiving day. I forgot which one we...
it was like one of the early ones.
One of the early ones. Yeah. And Ernesto brings cheesecake. Was it Ernesto Fabiola?
Mm.
Ernesto brings cheesecake. And, you know, everyone has a piece, stuff like that. There's a lot still left over. And at the end of the party...
This guy packs up his cheesecake, isn't
it? He packs up his cheesecake. And then Fabiola's like, oh, I want to take it home.
No, so what happened is what happened.
Like, hold on. Doesn't the food stay here in the house?
This is what happened.
You have a better version?
Yeah, I had the truth. Nothing but the truth. Okay. So we were all done eating. We were all like in the living room, just like talking shit, drinking, you know, having a good time, right? And I got a craving for some cheesecake.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, you know what? I'm going to get myself a cheesecake. I didn't say anything. Yeah. I'm like, I'm going to get myself a cheesecake.
Self slice.
So I go to his kitchen. And I'm looking around. I see no cheesecake, dude. I go in the fridge, no cheesecake.
Oh, yeah.
I go in the freezer, no cheesecake.
This is a better version.
And I'm like, the fuck? Like, what the fuck happened to cheesecake? And everybody's still at the party. So I'm like, something's off, right? So I come back out. I'm like, hey, bro. Like, I'm like, hey, guys, what happened to the cheesecake? And then I was like, oh, it's in my car.
He put it to go put it back.
Dude, he wasn't even leaving. He just, he just put it in his fucking car, dude. I'm like, bro, what are you doing? He's like, you guys won't need it. I'm like, no, dude. I'm like, whatever food comes to his house, Kamal stays with it.
Yeah, like it stays here. Like
it stays here.
You take pieces, but for the most, the bulk stays here.
Yeah, like you got
first
plates.
First off, I don't want to fucking take nothing home with me anyways.
You got plates or something, or you want to take a plate home?
Yeah.
Like if your own plate, your dish, whatever you brought the food in, fine. Right? But most people like leave the dish and like, hey, just like next time you see me, just bring the dish over after you clean it, right?
Yeah, correct.
But usually the host of the house keeps all the food.
For the most part.
Unless people want to take food home. Like, you want to take a plate.
You're not against it.
Against it, But then he looked at me. Like, they all looked, like, him and Fab looked all confused. So they're like, I'm like, what do you guys, don't, dude, it's not right.
The party's not even over yet.
Yeah, it's not even over yet.
Not even over, dude.
I just already packing up everything.
So he had to go back in his car, bring the fucking cheesecake over.
And walk a shake.
Walk a shake. He threw the blame on Fabiola.
With the fucking cheesecake.
Yeah, yeah. He's like, no, Fabiola told me to take my car.
God.
Yeah.
Like, what the fuck you guys doing here, man?
Like, come on, guys.
Like, weird ass shit, bro.
Hey, dude. People be on that shit, like. Hey, man, I'm not a fan for taking shit with me, bro. If I bring it, bro, it's left.
It's left.
Yeah,
it's
dude, left. I even write off the fucking container I brought it in. Dude, I'm not even gonna lie. I write off the container. Yeah, I'm like,
it's over.
I bought that container for this reason.
Yeah.
It's like bringing a 24 pack and only 4 beers we use. You're gonna take the 20 home? No, just leave the fucking 20.
Just leave the shit home.
Yeah.
Next time you come, you got a fucking beer to drink.
Yeah, you got a beer to drink.
Correct.
Fucking people.
People, man, that's weird, dude.
Is that the year that my sister made the turkey?
It's disgusting just being around them freaks. Go ahead.
Was that the year that my sister made the turkey?
I don't know. Oh, yeah. You want to hear another Kamal mistake?
Oh, yeah. That's a different one. That's a different one.
Okay,
doesn't matter.
Okay, you want to hear another fucking Kamal fucking mistake, dude?
This is all fucking lies.
I think this was the first time. This was the first time we decided to cook...
Thanksgiving.
Yeah, Thanksgiving at his house, right? Because otherwise, we always went to a restaurant and did all that, right? So,
probably
you know,
the best way to do it anyway.
Yeah,
still,
the best way to do it. But I was like, you know what? Hey, man, you know, this. We all like, let's cook this year. Mm-hmm. So, I was like, hey, Kamal, buy the turkey, and then I'll just come early that day and I'll cook it in your oven.
Yeah.
Like, I'll bring all the ingredients. You know, I got the butter, I got the salt, the pepper. The lemons, the rosemary. Like, I got everything, right? Everything to, like, get the turkey ready. Kamal, I don't think you were home.
No, I was where I sprayed at the time.
Yeah, like, yeah, you were doing something. And I go inside the house. I looked in the sink. No turkey. I was like, all right. It's weird. Maybe left in the fridge. Like, I'm like, fuck.
Yeah,
he right? might go in the fridge. In the fridge. I go in the fridge. No turkey. I'm like, oh. I mean, now he would be, I mean, he would be dumb to leave it in the freezer because it needs to defrost. You know, a turkey takes forever to fucking defrost.
Days,
right? Yeah. And I was like, but maybe he just put it on there, not, you know, maybe he got worried that it was warm or whatever, right? I'm like, you know, I'm thinking like a mall. I'm thinking like a rational person, right? I think. Go in the freezer, nothing there. So I call him, like, hey, bro, did you buy the turkey? And he's like, no. He's like, yeah, man, it's in the garage. It's fucking negative. Below zero, dude. And I'm like, in the garage? And I open the garage, and it's sitting on top of the trash can, dude. The fucking lid of the trash can, dude. And I'm like, oh, fuck. Bring that shit in, dude.
Bring the rock in.
It's a fucking break, dude. It is a fucking break, dude.
Fucking bring the rock in the house.
Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ.
So now I'm like, we got like fucking, we got like four or five hours to fucking turkey, for fucking Friendsgiving. And I'm just like, I don't even know what to fucking do, dude.
You can't do
this. I'm breaking all the rules when it comes to cooking poultry, right? I put some fucking warm water. I'm drowning in hot water. Come on, houses. Lukewarm water comes out of that fucking sink, dude. Hey, lukewarm water comes out of that sink, dude. And I'm like, fuck, dude, fuck. So it's not working fast enough, right? So I'm like, oh, he has a microwave. Maybe I can defrost it.
Yeah.
Maybe I can defrost it. Maybe, I don't know, maybe, right? And it could barely fit in there, right? So I hit the frost. And then after a minute, like, I hear the fucking the microwave going. And I'm like, oh, no. What's going on? I take the turkey out. It's fucking black. One side of it where the radiation was in it. It was fucking black, dude. And I was like, oh, dude. And you know, I'm a plan kind of guy, right?
Yeah.
And once Gamal ruined my plan, and I'm trying to, like, fix it, dude. Like, I'm getting heartbroken, dude.
Yeah, you started to feel it.
Oh, dude, I was getting so fucking mad, dude. And then I was like, fuck, dude. Fuck. So, like, I'm like, you know what, man? Everybody was coming and people were coming in. I was like, hey, guys, I tried my best. And I feel so guilty. This is what I did. I feel so guilty. Instead of this motherfucker, like, being like, hey, man, you know what? Let me fix this for you because I fucked it up for everybody. I was like, you know, I'm gonna drive out of my fucking way. I'm going to go buy a shitload of Popeye chicken.
Fire.
And bring it to the house.
Spicy.
So not only did I waste all that money on the greens and all this other shit that I bought for the house, but then I had to go and spend more money to fix this mistake. And this guy, you know what he did, dude? Got seconds. this guy got all the drumsticks.
I brought the loaf of bread, right?
Yeah, he got a loaf. He brought Italian bread to his home, dude.
No.
I didn't get rolls. I got Italian bread, bro.
Yeah, dude.
Corte simple,
oh, dude.
Dang it. Hey, bro.
Hey, that's one thing. Hold on.
All right,
hold on.
This is your side of the story?
No. You're all true about that one. But then we've had like multiple. The second year, my sister cooked, and she threw down. That was the best turkey we had. My sister fucking threw down. The third year, I think the third or fourth year, I went to go out and actually buy stuff. I actually bought the already glazed ham. I already bought the pre-made turkey, and we cooked at my crib.
Yeah.
All right, that was my how can I say?
No, but we all pitched in. Yeah, we all pitched in there. It wasn't like you just bought everything.
Now everyone pitched in.
Well, I did. Right, dude.
Now everybody pitched in.
Unless my money doesn't carry the same weight as yours, man.
Hey, no, your money isn't green, bro. Don't spend the same. Yeah. Don't spend the fucking same.
Not everybody. You
know, no, but in, like you know, like since then we've done
the last two, right?
We've ordered food from like Country Market.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Just to like avoid that shit. But
last year we went to Fuck with the Child.
Yeah. But here's the reason we do it that way, it's not so much of the food. Yeah. It's because we were like, hey, we want to drink, and we don't want to spend shitloads of money on alcohol, so let's do it at the house.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Because then we can just make drinks there. But then we do it at the house, nobody drinks.
Because we're all, well, here's the thing, we're all
like, nobody wants to drink. Full. Nobody wants to drink. And like, there's nothing more upsetting for me, like when I put like some hard work into making a fun cocktail, and then they leave the fucking drinks there, and I'm just like, oh, what?
What was the point?
What was the point?
I know the feeling.
What time are we at, Shrek?
55.
Okay. 55. Yeah. Yeah, it is one of those most...
It's when those when it comes to those meals, man, it's either you drink or you eat. True. You can't do both.
You can do both, bro.
You can do both. You can do both. You can do both. You just got
to do
it right.
The only way to do it right is to get drunk first and then eat. I'm happy. If I could do that, drink or get drunk to the point of blacking out and then eating, I'm all game.
I mean, I don't know. I
yeah, feel but, like... but then you start squeezing people. That's the issue. That's the issue. The issue is you started squeezing people, and by people we mean women.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Hold on. Relax. Right.
Pre-COVID, of course. Yeah,
pre-COVID, 2019. Summer 2019.
Everything Gamal committed pre-COVID.
Pre-COVID.
It's not liable to this current. current
yeah. Yeah.
Fucking Gamal, bro. Yeah. Hey, but on a side note, bro.
What's up, man? Talk to me.
Hey, your bulletproof vest for your nipple needs to come off, bro.
Hey, bro. Hey, it's bothering me. This episode's almost done, bro. Does it matter?
It's bothering me, bro.
Does it matter, bro?
You know what bothers me? That you think that's cool.
It's comfortable.
You know what I mean? No, it ain't comfortable. Because you know what's comfortable? Not having anything strapped on you, dude.
It's comfortable.
That's just cutting the circulation off your neck, my guy.
I don't need anything in my pockets.
That shit is hugging you for dear life, dude.
That shit.
I hear the fibers in the strap ripping apart.
It's stretchy, right?
I'm hoping the mic is catching those fucking.
This ripped in the fibers.
You know, I feel like it's Gamal from fucking Ace Ventura When Nature Calls.
Oh,
when the monkey is like falling from the strap, and the strap is like the buckle, like you know what I'm talking about?
No, fuck that. When he's coming out the rhino's ass. Fucking A, bro. Hey, bro. Get rid of that shit, bro.
Yeah, get rid of it. Yeah, you gotta stop.
If you're gonna get one,
I'm gonna upgrade, man.
No, hey, no. You're not fucking 12, my boy.
You're not 12.
You're not 12. I'm just glad he's wearing fucking ankle socks with fucking low cut shoes, dude. Usually just fucking those fucking two socks are coming up all the way up to his fucking knee, dude.
You can tell where it starts. Yeah. My leg,
bro.
Where the crew socks go. Yeah.
This guy.
I'm just surprised this guy thinks he knows he understands style.
I can't say but I mean, I dabble a little bit.
I dabble.
He dabbles in a lot of things.
What does it look? Walmart Spring? what are we looking at? Walmart Spring 2022?
This is pre-COVID.
Oh, it's pre-COVID.
It's 2019. It's 2019.
Summer 2019.
Summer 2019.
Summer 2019.
It was a good year.
Hey, bro. No matter the year.
Yeah. You have Kamal in the early 2000s? He's killing it right now, dude.
Hey, dude.
He's
killing
it, dude. I'm hip,
he's
dude.
He's hip, bro.
Hey, bro.
He's with the times.
Go fucking melt on that side of the couch, right, bro?
Hey, bro. Listen, bro. Stay over there, bro. Stay over there. With this tight-ass thing on your neck.
What you want, Pablo Escobar?
You know Pablo Escobar? Kill you right now, dude.
Pablo Escobar and Popeye, bro. All right.
Hey. fucking bing-bong right here, dude.
Bing-bong. Hey, dude, Shrek in Spanish? Dude. Most funny shit ever, dude.
Hey, what? Dude.
Shrek in Spanish?
Oh, Shrek in Spanish, yeah.
That's where the bing-bong came from.
No, I'm talking about el pan. Well, the little monillo.
Have you ever seen the video?
Yes.
That's what you're talking about, dude.
No, I'm talking about the fucking the bear and the freaking bread, dude. All you do is eat carbs, my dude.
Little bread?
Yeah.
No, fiber now, dude.
Yeah,
stay full.
So you stay full?
Hey, dude. Hey.
What's up, dude? Talk to me.
Another side note, bro. Juice cleanse, bro. We should go on a juice cleanse.
Yeah, but that...
We're talking about keto.
You know what that problem is? That problem is that it affects his diet. That's the issue.
Fucking A.
That's the issue.
You made sense there, though.
If it's affecting his diet, he can't fuck with it, man.
We're going keto, bro.
Gamal's diet is very, very particular.
We're going keto.
So. We ain't going keto, bro. You're supposed to lose 100 pounds by the end of the year. What happened?
I was... Oh, dude, you know what? We haven't even fucking mentioned it.
What?
The show. The comedy show, man.
The comedy show.
Because I was going to say, I'm telling him to like lose some weight for the comedy show.
Yeah.
I'm working on it. But I was like, yeah, but you know, let's end the podcast on this. Look, guys, we have a comedy show July 14th at the Kobe Theater in Aurora, Illinois. We have great comedians. We have Ken Flores. We have what?
You sounded beaner as fuck.
Dude, stop thinking about food. Dude, life's just more into life than that, dude. God damn, dude. Como like, un quesadilla con... Comría de taco de...
Cochela.
Cochela. Okay. Cochela, yeah. Cochela look real good on the fucking on meat fork, dude. But yeah, we got
Ken Flores.
We have Luis
Acevedo.
No, Aravelo.
Aravelo, fuck.
We have Deanna Ortiz.
Jamal.
And we have Jamal G. Guys, tickets are on sale. go to Eventbrite. The link is in the description. Link is in the Instagram bio. Link is everywhere that we're that we have a that we have a social media platform.
Heavy promo this month. Heavy promo.
Yeah, tickets only $25, guys. So we hope to see everybody there. Let's sell this show out. So
it will sell out.
So we can continue doing this stuff for you guys. And Shaq, tell them where they can find you, bro.
All right, you can find me on Instagram, credit_priest. You can find me on TikTok, credit_priest. All your credit needs, come to this guy.
Guys, of course, hit me up.
What was that laugh? Where did that laugh come from, dude?
I was just
it was laughing. It was like a fill-in. Did you feel that? God, you can find me. You laugh like you're a rich white man, dude. You broke brown, man. You brown and broke, dude.
You broke A.
You got the worst quality, man. I'm
broke. You guys can find me on Instagram, Gamal Diaz.
Hey, guys, thank you for listening. Thank you for watching. Like always, this is Dan Insomnia. Sign off.
Cheers.
Signing out, guys.
Hey guys, Ramon from Daily Insomnia. Thank you for watching our video. Make sure to hit the subscribe button right here. Watch our mixology videos up here. And if you want to see our latest episode, it's right here. Like always, guys, this is Daily Insomnia. Sign off.